Hello everyone. We all know that Excel is a great tool for data analysis. But did you know that you can also use Excel to extract live data from the web? For instance, you can use Excel to extract live stock dividend and dividend yield information from the web and use it to analyze your stock and dividend information. In this video, I'll show you how to use Excel to pull up data for a bunch of stocks by using Power Query. All right, I've come over to Excel, and the first thing we require is a set of company ticker symbols that we're going to test. So I have a set of 6 ticker symbols for 6 companies, and the information we are looking for is the dividend, dividend yield, and the dividend date. This is how we want to get the information back. We would like to get the dividend yield and dividend date for the 6 companies that we have listed on the table in the other worksheet. Let's go to finance.yahoo.com and search for a stock. So you'll notice that there are a bunch of tabs on this URL, and the information we want is located in some of these tabs. So seems like the statistics tab has some of the information we require in this section called dividends and splits. So let's try to extract this data. So we'll copy this URL and store it someplace. All right, the first thing we're going to do is convert our data into a table. You can also use the Ctrl T shortcut for this. Now we need to get this data into Power Query by going to the data menu and choosing get from table or range, or you can right click and get it into the Power Query editor. Let's give our table a name. We'll call it stock tickers, and let's apply a single step of transformation, that is to change the data type to text. The next thing we're going to do is to create a blank query and use the URL that you've saved to pull in data from that URL. Let's paste the URL from Yahoo Finance. Now here you'll see a list of tables. These tables correspond to the tables available on the Yahoo Finance website. And the table we're interested in is this one called Dividends and Splits. We confirm that it has the information we require and click on OK. Let's refresh to get the latest updated data. Now, if you notice, the first row must actually be part of the data and not a header. So let's go to the home menu and choose this option here called use headers as the first row of our data. So now we have all the data that we require. Next, go to source, click on advanced editor. Now, we don't want our URL to be hard-coded. We want it to take an input ticker, which will have the text data type, and we want to return a table. So this is the syntax that we use. And wherever the MSFT was hard-coded, we need to change it to to point to input ticket. So we're going to change the URL to concatenate the hard-coded portion with this input called input ticket. Confirm that no syntax errors are detected. Click on done. And here we have our function ready. Let's give it a meaningful name. Let's call it fx_getDividendInfo. And let's test out this function by providing an input ticker for Microsoft. Click on invoke and you'll see that you're getting the information you require. We now need to look at our table containing all the 6 tickers, and we want to apply this custom function to every one of these tickers. So go to add column, invoke custom function, select the function fx_getDividendInfo and choose the input ticker as the column containing company ticker symbols and click on OK. So you'll see that Power Query has extracted the data for all these 6 tickers. Click on the double arrow icon and click on OK to get the data for all these tickers into Power Query. Now we just confirm that we have all the data that we need. And if you think all the data is here, then you can go to home and click on close and load to get the data back into a worksheet in Excel. The famous Windows loading screen, and we just need to wait a bit until you get all the data that you need. So we see that all the data has come over to Excel in a new worksheet. Now the beauty of this method is that anytime your stock ticker's source changes, you can click on data refresh to get updated data for an updated set of tickers. For instance, I've added the stock ticker symbol for Ford. Click on data refresh. And in a minute, you should see the dividend and dividend date information for the Ford Motor Company in the same worksheet in Excel. If you scroll down, you'll see that we have all the information for Ford, including the dividend date. So if you get NA, don't worry. Only the information that's available on the website can be retrieved by Excel. We can confirm the information for Ford by going to Yahoo Finance. And if you scroll down, you'll see that the same values are present on the website as well. So this is how you can use the Power Query feature in Excel to get updated and live dividend data. Let's go through the process once again. We start by listing out our tickers. Click on data or right click and select get data from table or range. Once you get your table into Power Query, change the data type of this column to text and give your table a meaningful name. After that, right click, choose new query and select web. Paste in the Yahoo Finance URL, click on OK. From the displayed tables, choose the table that you require and click on OK. Now you see that this must be part of the data. So select use headers as first row. Go to the advanced editor. Let's make it an input based function. Let's give a name of stock as text. And we want to return a table. So let's replace all instances of MSFT with this stock input. click on done. So we have created our function and we can test it on a stock ticker. If you have tested it and seen it to work correctly, then you are ready to call this function for each ticker in your table of tickers. Let's give our function a meaningful name, getStockInfo. Go to our table, click on invoke custom function, select the function that we just wrote and click on OK. Click on the double arrow icon to expand all the columns, click on OK. Confirm that you have the data you require and click on home, close and load to get the data back into Excel. Wait a bit until all the rows are loaded. And here you have the data for all the stock tickers that you had selected. If you need to update your table, add a new entry and click on Data Refresh to get data for the updated table of stock tickers. So this is how you can use Excel to pull in live stock data from a website such as Yahoo Finance.